Hello friends, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Ajay Solke, presently working as Assistant Professor, University School of Management, Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra, Haryana. In this module, we are going to discuss the various ILO's conventions and recommendations. Upon completion of the module, the student should be able to understand the role and significance of ILO in regulating labor standards and situations across the world. Major conventions and treaties of ILO having implications for India. What are those conventions which has been ratified by India and the initiatives taken by Government of India concerning the same conventions? Conventions which has not been ratified by India and the problems and the challenges in line which hampers its ratification. Relation of ILO and India in the globalized world. Relation of ILO and India in the globalized world. The International Labour Organization is a United Nations agency dealing with labour issues, particularly international labour standards and decent work for all. 185 of the 193 United Nations member states are members of the ILO in 1969. The organization received the Nobel Peace Prize for improving peace among the classes, pursuing justice for workers, and providing technical assistance to other developing nations. The ILO was founded in April 1919, primarily in response to humanitarian concern over the conditions of workers who are being exploited with no consideration for their health, their family lives, or their professional and social advancement. India and the International Labour Organization. India is a founder member of the International Labour Organization, which came into existence in 1919. At present, the ILO has 185 members. A unique feature of the International Labour Organization is its tripartite character. The membership of the ILO ensures the growth of tripartite system in the member countries. At every level in the organization, governments are associated with two other social partners, namely the workers and the employers. All the three groups are represented on almost all the deliberative organs of the ILO and share responsibility in conducting its work. ILO is having very unique tripartite structure, which consists of three important bodies, that is workers, governments and employers. In its truly tripartite nature, workers are representing one group, government is having the two representatives, employers are having again one representative. How ILO works? ILO comprises of three bodies, International Labour Conference, Governing Body and International Labour Office. These three are the major organs of the ILO. Very first of all, International Labour Conference. It is the General Assembly of the ILO which meets every year in the month of June. Governing Body. It is the Executive Council of the ILO which meets three times in a year in the months of March, June and November. Third is International Labour Office, which is a permanent secretariat. The work of the conference and the governing body is supplemented by regional conferences, regional advisory committees, industrial and analogous committees, committee of experts, panel of consultants, special conference and meetings, etc. International Labour Conference. Except for the interruption caused by the Second World War, the International Labour Conference has continued since its first session in 1919 to meet at least once a year. The conference, assisted by the governing body, adopts biennial program and budget, adopts international labour standards in the form of conventions and recommendations, and provides a forum for discussing social, economic and labour related issues. India has regularly and actively participated in the conference through its tripartite delegations. The conference has so far had four Indian presidents, naming first is Sir Atul Chatterjee in 1927, Shri Jagjivan Ram, Ministry of Labour, 1950, Dr. Nagendra Singh, President, International Court of Justice, 1970, and lastly Shri Ravindra Verma, Minister of Labour and Parliamentary Affairs, 1979. There have also been eight Indian vice presidents of the International Labour Conference, two from the government group, three from the employers and three from the workers group. Indians have chaired the important committees of the conferences like Committee on Application of Standards, Selection Committee and Resolution Committee. Governing body. The governing body of the International Labour Organization is the executive wing of the organization. It is also tripartite in character. Since 1922, India has been holding a non-elective seat on the governing body as one of the 10 countries of the chief industrial importance. Indian employers and workers' representatives have been elected as members of the governing body from time to time. Four Indians have so far been elected chairman of the governing body. They are Sir Atul Chatterjee, Shri Shamal Dhari Lal, Shri S. T. Mirani, Shri B. G. Deshmukh. Earlier, the governing body of ILO functioned through its various committees. India was a member of all six committees of the governing body. The bodies are Programming, Planning and Administrative, Freedom of Association, Legal Issues and International Labour Standards, Employment and Social Policy, Technical Cooperation and Sectoral and Technical Meetings and Related Issues. Now the governing body of ILO functions through its various sections and India takes part in all the proceedings of the section during the sessions of the governing body. The various sessions are Institutional Section, Policy Development Section, Legal Issues and International Labour Standards, Program Financial and Administrative Section, High Level Section, Working Party on the Functioning of the Governing Body and the International Labour Conference. The International Labour Office. The International Labour Office, Geneva, provides the secretariat for all the conferences and other meetings and is responsible for the day-to-day implementation of decisions taken by the conference, governing body, etc. Indians have held positions of importance in the International Labour Office. International Labour Standards, ILO Conventions. The principal means of action in the ILO is the setting up the International Labour Standards in the form of conventions and recommendations. Now, what exactly are the conventions? Conventions are the international treaties and are instruments which create legally binding obligations on the countries that ratify them. Recommendations are non-binding and set out guidelines orienting national policies and actions. The ILO instruments have provided guidelines and a useful framework for the evolution of legislative and administrative measures for the protection and advancement of the interest of labour. How are international labour standards made? International labour standards, both the conventions as well as the recommendations, are drawn up by the representatives of the governments, employers and workers and are adopted at the ILO's annual International Labour Conference. Once adopted, a standard is to be submitted by the member states or to their competent authority for consideration. In the case of convention, for ratification. Ratification of conventions. Ratification of an ILO conventions are voluntary. Ratification is a formal procedure whereby a state accepts the convention as a legally binding instrument. A country subject to the ILO's regular supervisory system responsible for ensuring that ratified conventions are applied. Slide 22. The various subjects which are acting as the core areas of international labour standards are freedom of association, collective bargaining, industrial relation, forced labour, child labour, equality of opportunity and treatment, tripartite consultations, labour administration and inspection, employment policy and promotion, vocational guidance and training, employment security, wages, working time, occupational safety and health, social security, maternity protection, social policy, migrant workers, seafarers, fishermen, dock workers, indigenous and tribal peoples, specific categories of workers. The core conventions of the ILO. The eight core conventions of the ILO, also called as the Fundamental and the Human Rights Conventions, are: very first is Forced Labour Convention, the convention number 29. Second is Abolition of Forced Labour Convention, convention number 105. Third is Equal Remuneration Convention, convention number 100. Fourth is Discrimination Employment Occupation Convention, Convention number 111. Fifth is Freedom of Association and Protection of Rights to Organized Convention, Convention number 87. Sixth, Right to Organize and Collective Bargaining Convention, Convention number 98. Seven, Minimum Age Convention, Convention number 138. And lastly, Eighth, Worst Form of Child Labor Convention, Convention number 182. Convention number 1, 2, 3 and 4 have been ratified by India, but Convention number 5, 6, 7, 8 have not been ratified by India so far. ILO conventions ratified by India. At present, there are 45 ILO conventions and one protocol which is ratified by India. The details of the ratifications are: Fundamental Conventions, 4 have been ratified out of 8. Governance Conventions, 3 out of 4 have been ratified by India. Regarding Technical Conventions, 38 has been ratified by India out of 177. Out of 45 conventions and one protocol ratified by India, of which 42 are in force, 4 conventions and 0 protocol have been denounced. None have been ratified in the past 12 months. The detailed list has been attached in the quadrant number 4 for your kind perusal. ILO's core conventions, which has been not been ratified by India. Convention number 87, Freedom of Association and Protection of the Right to Organize. Convention number 98, Right to Organize and Collective Bargaining. Convention number 138, that is minimum age for entry to employment and work. Convention number 182, accompanying recommendation number 190 on worst form of child labor. What exactly the convention number 87 is and why India has not ratified it? Convention number 87 concerning freedom of association and protection of the right to organize provides for the right of workers and employers without any distinction to establish and join organization of their own choosing without previous authorization. Their organizations have the right to form or join federations and confederations, including those at the international level. Convention number 98. Convention number 98 concerning right to organize and collective bargaining, which aims to protect the right to organize and to promote voluntary collective bargaining. The guarantees provided for under these two conventions are by and large available to workers in India by means of constitutional provisions, laws and regulations and practices. What are the reasons for non-ratification of the convention number 89 and 98? The main reason for non-ratification of the above two conventions is due to the reservations expressed by Department of Personnel and Training, because ratification would create legally binding obligation which are inconsistent with our laws and practices. Department of Personnel Training view is that ratification of these conventions would involve granting of certain rights that are prohibited under the statutory rules for government employees, namely to strike work, restrictions on maintaining any political funds, to openly criticize government policies, to freely accept financial contribution, to freely join foreign organizations, etc. Steps taken by Ministry of Labor and Employment on Convention number 87 and Convention number 98. The Ministry of Labour and Employment is in regular discussion with various ministries on the possibility of ratifying Convention number 87 and 98. We are also in touch with ILO for seeking technical assistance in this regard. Ratification of ILO conventions, especially core conventions including Convention number 87 and 98, has been identified as a key priority area in our Decent Work Country program for 2013 and 17. Convention number 138, Minimum Age. ILO Convention number 138 concerning minimum age for entry to employment and work was adopted by the International Labour Conference at its 58th session in June 1973. This convention is one of the 8 core conventions of the ILO, being referred to as fundamental or basic human rights conventions, and the ILO has been very active in promoting its ratification. Each country ratifying this convention undertakes to pursue a national policy designed to ensure the effective abolition of child labor, specify a minimum age for entry to employment or work which will not be less than the ages of completion of compulsory schooling, to raise this progressively to a level consistent with the fullest physical and mental development of young people. Guarantee that the minimum age of entry to any type of employment or work which is likely to compromise health, safety of morals of young persons shall not be less than 18 years. The Government of India has adopted a multi-pronged strategy for the eradication of child labour, which is as follows. A legislative action plan has been formulated in the form of Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Act 1986. Project-based action plan in areas of high concentration of child labour under National Child Labour Project Scheme. Focus on general development program for the benefit of the families of child labour. The Cabinet has approved the proposal of Ministry of Labour and Employment for amending the Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Act 1986, which is in line with the ratification of Convention No. 138. An amendment bill to prohibit employment of children below the age of 14 years in all occupations and processes have been introduced in the Parliament. The bill also proposes to prohibit the employment of adolescents between the age of 14 and 18 years in hazardous occupations and processes specified in the schedule to be proposed amendment bill. These amendments, when approved, would enable India to ratify ILO Conventions 138 and 132. Convention number 182 accompanying recommendations number 190 on worst form of child labour. ILO Convention number 182 and the accompanying recommendation number 190 concerning worst form of child labour was adopted by the ILO in its 87th session at Geneva in June 1999. Convention number 182 is one of the 8 core conventions of the ILO, being referred to as fundamental or basic human rights conventions. Main provisions of the convention number 182. For the purpose of this convention, the term child shall apply to all persons under the age of 18. For the purpose of this convention, the term worst form of child labour comprises all forms of slavery or practices similar to slavery, such as the sale and trafficking of children, including forced or compulsory recruitment of children for use in armed conflict. The use, procuring or offering of a child for prostitution, for the production of pornography or for pornographic performances. The use, procuring or offering of a child for illicit activities, in particular of the production and trafficking of drugs, as defined in the relevant international treaties. Work which by its very nature or the circumstances in which it is carried out is likely to harm the health, safety or morals of the children. What is the Government of India's stand on ILO Convention 182? The worst form of child labour are already prohibited under various acts, namely slavery, debt, bondage and forced or compulsory labour through Bonded Labour System Abolition Act 1976. Prostitution, pornography and pornographic performances banned through Indian Penal Code, Immoral Trafficking Prevention Act 1956. Production and trafficking for drugs has been banned by Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act 1985. Child labour below 14 years in hazardous occupation is prohibited under the Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Act 1986. The reasons for non-ratification of the various conventions. The Government of India agrees with the principles of the convention. The convention could not be ratified so far because it mandates the ages of 18 years for prohibition of children from employment in specified hazardous occupations, whereas according to the Child Labour Prohibition Regulation Act 1986, the minimum specified age for employment in the hazardous occupation is 14 years. The Government of India follows the policy of ratifying the ILO Convention only when the existing laws and the practices are in conformity with the provisions of the said convention. Cabinet has approved the proposal of Ministry of Labour and Employment for amending the Child Labour Prohibition and Regulation Act 1986, which is in line with the ratification of Convention No. 182. Friends, I hope you have understood the contents well. You can also refer to other quadrants of this module for testing your knowledge and having some more input on theme of the module. Happy learning!